Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of creatnprocess. Today we'll be creating a vector Meteor graphic design using Illustrator and Photoshop. To design this, we'll first create a structure using a star and a line segment tool. Then we'll apply grayscale color to each segment, and finally, apply a concrete texture to design. So let's begin the tutorial. Open a new Illustrator document. Select the star tool and left click to open the attributes panel. Here, set the number of points to 20, radius 1 to 22mm, radius 2 to 23mm, and click OK. This will create a star with 20 points. We'll remove the fill color and reduce the stroke thickness to 0.5 points. Next, using a direct selection tool, we'll modify the shape by tweaking each of the vertices. Make it a little uneven, at the same time maintain the circular shape. Now, we'll draw a curve line in the middle using the pen tool. Use the handles to maintain the curve and adjust the points using the direct selection tool. Next, we'll divide the shapes into two halves. So select the curve and increase the stroke thickness to 3 points. Then go to Object, Path, Outline Stroke. This will convert the curves into fill object. Now select both the shapes. Then using the Shape Builder tool, extract the top and the bottom shape and combine the middle shape. Now select the middle shape and delete it. Next, remove the fill color for both the shapes by clicking on this icon. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to draw out triangular segments within each of the shapes. But before that, let's modify a few of the anchor points using the direct selection tool. Then with the help of pen tool, we'll start drawing out the lines. Click, click, and click to get a straight line. And we'll finish it at this corner. We can also use line segment tool to draw out the lines. Create triangular shapes using the lines. Make sure to snap each of the endpoints so that there is no empty space left out. Try to include big and small divisions. Do the same for the other shape. Create triangles using line segments. Once done, we'll do the final refinement. Click and drag to select bunch of anchor points using the direct selection tool and move them to do the proper placement. Set the points in a place where it would give more dynamic look to the design. These little changes will give more volume in the appearance. Lastly, adjust the border anchor points to maintain the circular shape. Now, the next step is to apply grayscale color to each of the triangular pieces. To do that, we can extract out the individual pieces in two ways. First, select all the stroke outlines, and using the Shape Builder tool, you can click on each of the sections to extract the shapes. Another way is by using the Pathfinder options. Under Pathfinder, you can use divide options to extract the section all at once. Then apply a fill color from the color swatches. After this, right click and ungroup the shapes. Next, select the rectangle tool and draw out a vertical rectangle. Click on this icon to apply a gradient color to the shape. Then with the gradient tool, click and drag down to apply it vertically. Now go to the object, expand, and under expand attributes panel, set the number of specified objects to 10 and click OK. This will give us 10 steps of color going from white to black. Next, ungroup it and release clipping mask. Then delete the clipping mask shape. Now we'll apply color to each of the individual segments. Select and choose color from the grayscale using the eye picker. Do this for all the shapes. If you find that any two segments are not separated properly, set the vertex to the endpoints and separate the triangle using the Shape Builder tool. This way, fill up all the segments. We are giving bright color on the sides facing left, and as it goes to right side surface, apply darker color. This will give depth and contrast to the design. Next, draw the shape for the empty space using the pen tool. Then arrange it to back up the design. Now edit the shape using the direct selection tool and use handles to maintain the curves. Lastly, do the final adjustments with the colors. Now we'll use Photoshop to apply texture to our design. So open a new Photoshop document. Select a design and drag and drop it to Photoshop document. scale up the size. Next, we'll import a metal texture. You can find number of free texture in internet. You can use concrete or metal texture for this design. Scale on the texture size and place it on top of our design. Now with the oil pressed, you can see this symbol. Click it and it will apply clipping mask. Change the layer mode to multiply and it will give us a nice metallic texture. Let's apply hue and saturation adjustment layer. Click on this icon to apply it only to the texture. Here, we'll adjust the hue value. We can also change the position of the texture by clicking and dragging. Also, adjust the hue value to add a little reddish tone. Next, create another duplicate of our main design and place it on top. This will remove the clipping mask, so apply it again for both texture and the hue and saturation adjustment layer. Now select the top layer and change the layer mode to overlay. Reduce the fill value to around 31%. Next, add a new brightness and contrast adjustment layer to give a little contrast to the design. Now select the texture layer and change the angle of rotation using the transform option. Next, add a new layer. We'll use this layer to add color tone. Apply clipping mask, choose blue color from the color swatches and change the layer mode to color. Now choose a soft brush and with the low opacity start applying it over the lower region. Then choose red color from the color picker and apply it on the top region. Set the layer opacity to 80%. Also set the hue value to -3 and the saturation value to +11. Now lock the background layer and select all the other layers to scale up the size and to reposition. Next, we'll add a depth of field. So select our main design and go to Filter, Blur Gallery, Irish Blur. This will give us a circular blur. Increase the diameter and drag in the circular icons. We'll set the blur value to 18 pixels and click OK. Now we'll apply the same effects to our texture layer. So with the alt pressed, click and drag over the texture layer. To do the adjustments, double click on the blur gallery. Here, set its position to the center, reduce the size and click OK. Lastly, we'll type out the title text. Scale up the size, we'll choose Jasmine UPC italic font for our text. Do the proper placement, choose dark blue color for our text from the texture using the color picker. Finally, we have completed designing a vector meteor graphic design. During the process, we have used very simple techniques to create clean and iconic design. We have seen how to create triangular segments and apply a texture. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.